Yeah, DW, I talked to a couple of crew chiefs this morning. They said over the last number of years, the O course, they focused everything on turning to the right. They kind of just got through the left-handers. But they said, especially with this carousel being a long sweeping left hand, they've kind of focused everything arrow-wise and chassis-wise to turn into the left, almost like you would a short track.
And Larry, that's exactly what we used to do when we came here. We used to focus on that carousel because it was such a big part of the track.
So here we're going into turn three, a little downhill left-hander, come up over this crest. That's 3A. Use a little bit of that curb on the right. Takes you all the way out. Now this is where the new section, this is fascinating to me. I didn't think we were going to be able to see any passes going into turn four, but we just saw Martin Truex Jr. do that. Here's a fast kink turn five.
Oh, yeah.
And then look at this. You're absolutely blind coming over this crest.
And if you overcook it and come over that hill a little too hot, you've got a little bit of a runoff room, but not much.
And you could hear how much he's playing with the throttle, not able to get wide open through the carousel as he comes downhill. And now it's back uphill, hard braking into turn seven.
And this is a hairpin, like turn 11. It's just one big, long right turn.
Well, and going back to what Larry McReynolds was talking about, if you're going to set your car up to try to turn left more significantly than right, then when you get to that slow right-hander in turn 11, turn 7, you're going to have a serious problem trying to make up speed, get the car rotated.
I think turn 7 is going to be like, excuse me.
So we come to turn 10, 139 miles an hour.
Yep.